the students gain a really good insight into a different culture and how sport is playing in different country. The opportunities or the lack of opportunities available in a country like Malta. It also gave the students an opportunity to live away from home, experience the culture of Malta, and to experience coaching in different environments.
I look into the window of my mind. Reflections of the fears I know I've left behind. I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending.
We're involved in projects where students get sent from abroad. They apply for funds from their college, and when they get the funding, they are sent here for an experience in their field of studies. We've hosted sports students, sport leaders, netball students, hairdressers, nurses, fitness instructors, special needs students, retail, amongst others. Well, the students have a wonderful experience when they're visiting another country. They're experiencing their field of studies, but in a different context.
To make you feel proud. It's never too late.
Being able to understand a different culture is something I do like to do. But you know, it's just getting the experience of working with children, because I do enjoy working with children from previous experience that I do have. And you know, it'd be interesting to see how different children from a different culture might react.
Made up of people with lots of different impairments, so we do a lot of advocacy work. We also are very interested in sports, and we have been amongst the first groups in Malta to actually try and introduce wheelchair sports to the island. We play tournaments with wheelchair basketball and handball and rugby. We also have some carbon fibre racing wheelchairs, which we have used to do 10k things in. So we've got a racing wheelchair team, and we've recently just been given a go-ahead by the government to start the Malta National Wheelchair Basketball Team. Wheelchair sport is really in its infancy here, but we have been trying to push wheelchair sports for a very long time.
Still so many answers I don't know. There are so many answers. Realize that to question is how we grow. To question is to grow. So I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending.
We get from all over. Last year I had a team all the way from Australia. Generally 90% of our teams, they all come from UK, different part of UK. We get a team from Ireland, Scotland, and this year we broke all the record. We got 27 teams this year, which will be including you.
We
do is, it's for the touring team, they get an exposure of coming and playing abroad, playing in a different environment, different pitch. And we play a mixture of age groups, mixture of nationality here. So for them, it's an experience. Coming in summer, especially if it is 37 degrees, if you're playing in the heat, and you don't get this exposure and the experience playing in England. Definitely. For us, it's a very social event, like it's a relaxed event. You could see the way we had some bowlers to come on bowl and we were changing them after one over. So it clearly shows it was, we didn't take it seriously. What have you done today to make you feel proud? It's never too late to try. What have you done today to make you feel proud? You could be so many.
Into how students performed in their coaching with other students and in a different environment.
Done today to make you feel proud, yeah. We need a change, yeah. Do it today, yeah. I can feel my spirit rising, change, yeah. We need a change, yeah. So do it today, yeah. Cause I can see it there.
Trip to last longer because I think that the more the students got involved with the Maltese children, they got to learn a little bit more the names, what they can expect from the students. I think there was a lot more to see as well as regards the culture, and I think the students would have gained a great deal from having a few more days there, probably another week.
So many.